started working for the city in the finance department in, I think, May of 1970. After about 8 or 9 months, they were looking for a director of the Civic Center. It was pretty new, and they posted an ad for an administrative assistant, and it would have been a promotion for me, so I applied for it and got it. There were no typical days. We were just developing, bringing in acts into the Civic Center. There hadn't been a lot going on until John Tidwell got there as Leisure Services Director. He was the best boss I ever had. I handled the booking, so I had the booking book. Before you got an act in, their assistants would call for available dates, and then when they were organizing a tour, and then they would call back and hold dates. And then they would narrow it down as the time got closer, and you had to have separation between rock groups and rhythm and blues. If there was already a rock group booked the first half of the month, you couldn't do another one until maybe the last week of the month. I was with the city from May of 70 to sometime in the fall of either 83 or 84. When I first went to work for the city, she was very young. When she was 10, 11, 12, I'd take her with me to work during the summer. And we had ice skating for 2 weeks every year, and she spent half the day out on the ice learning to skate and did really well. She was looked after. She was 12 or 13, I guess, at that time. But that's sort of when I decided I maybe needed a different occupation. Usually a radio station would have a photographer and they would give away a meet and greet as part of a promotion, and I would go take them back. And that's how I wound up backstage at several. I wasn't always back there if they didn't have a meet and greet and I didn't have a reason to go, because that's really when my work was going on. We had to balance the box office and pay everybody the same night. They don't do that now, but we did it.
Counting flowers on the wall. Playing solitaire till dawn with the deck of 51. Smoking cigarettes and watching Captain Kangaroo. Now don't tell me.
I think at their sound check, I decided to take a picture, and I walked in front of them while they were singing with my camera, and I took a picture, and they stopped, and I can't remember his name, but the one with the deep voice stopped everything and said, "I'll go home with you and sit on your dresser." It was so funny.
Let's go back to my room and make my day complete. Counting flowers on the wall, that don't bother me at all.
My music makes you dance and gives you spirit to take a chance. And I wrote some rock and roll so you can move.
Wow, Baron Analo. He had a good stage presence.
Well, that's a real fine place to start. From me, it's for you, it's from you, it's for me, it's a worldwide symphony.
Just hold me close and lovely. Tell me it won't end. Feels so right.
Down in the boondocks.
Billy Joe Royal, down in the boondocks. He was from Garden City. The person that I was dating at the time, Bobby Glisson, was his drummer when he got famous.
Down in the boondocks.
And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free.
Right after that was snapped, he did this dip, and my head almost hit the floor and cracked me up. I went, whoa.
In the still of the night.
Bonnie Millsap. And Ann was the station manager for Wave 97. She knew him from her high school. He lived in her neighborhood and rode the bus. And when she walked up, she whispered in his ear, "I'm Ann," and she said her maiden name. And he said, "Well, what are you doing here?" he remembered her from long ago.
So right, lost in the 50s tonight.
And it's knowing I'm not shackled by forgotten words and bonds and the ink stains that are dried upon some line.
Glen Campbell, I love his music. Gentle on My Mind's one of the best I think he ever did.
By the rivers of my memory, it keeps you ever gentle on my mind.
I'm all out of love, I'm so lost without you. I know you were right, believing for so long. I'm all out of love, what am I without you? I can't be too late to say that I was so wrong.
Lady, I'm your knight in shining armor, and I love you.
The promoter's wife and I had gone to the drugstore earlier in the evening to find Tums or Rolaids for him because he had acid indigestion. The promoter's wife said if he would be fine if he didn't eat so much.
My love, there's so many ways I want to say I love you.
That was when I was starting to really appreciate what my mother did for a living, because I was a huge Flock of Seagulls fan, huge Go-Go's fan, and them together in one show, oh my God. My bedroom door covered top to bottom with adhesive backstage passes, which they don't use anymore now.
Oh, you ripped them all out.
I did my best. I only got like five and we left them. That's another thing I wish we had photos of. The interior of my bedroom walls that were completely plastered in metal rock bands when we lived in Bloomingdale. Before or after the concert, but I was major Kiss fan all the way from age 5, Rock and Roll Over album from hanging out with my cousin Bubba. I want to say they came through on that Rock and Roll Over tour, giant damn snake boots that were as tall as I was. I mean, damn, and red eyes, and the platforms was the teeth. She did tell a story about believing she accidentally saw at least one member, if not the group, of Kiss without their makeup on. And this is, you know, as we all know, Kiss was never seen without their makeup. There was like all these big bounties for anybody that could get a picture of Kiss without their makeup. And she accidentally saw it, and it turned into a big old fat hairy deal, all kind of melting down, freaking out kind of stuff. Like, I don't know what happened as a result of that. I just remember she was having a conversation with somebody and I thought, wow. That's a personally autographed promo picture of Charlie Daniels that Mom brought home
to Kim.
Personally autographed directly to me.